with me this afternoon from Futura Medical. I'm joined by James Barder. James, good to see you.
Andrew, good to see you as well.
Just kick us off, James, with a status update on Med 3000. How's that going?
Yes, it's going very well. We announced the sort of headline results back in December. But this morning there was a webcast, which again I strongly urge people to listen to, where Ken very eloquently went through all the data points. I mean, the results are truly extraordinary, whichever way you want to look at it. If you look at it by country, if you look at it by disease severity, we're getting highly statistically significant data. I mean, it really is quite remarkable and very surprising in many respects, but very exciting as well. So Ken has disclosed that we're going through all that this morning. The key thing we're now focused on is obviously the regulatory submission. And again, we gave an update to the market this morning in that regard. We'd previously commented about the European submission, and we're well on track to submit that for regulatory approval by July this year. And we've had a very good constructive meeting with the FDA. We are going to go back for a second meeting with them. We've always been advised that the FDA approaches it from a more iterative perspective. They, if you go along with the journey with them rather than just banging in the dossier, you're less likely to get unpleasant surprises. And you only get a certain amount of time, and we have a lot of data to go through. And to be honest, we haven't got the full clinical study report, which is due in the next couple of weeks, but we're going to go back with them. So it'll take a little bit longer to submit the regulatory submission, but we're on track to deliver that in September. But we hope, because we'll address in the intervening period questions that they may raise, especially about data sufficiency, we'd hope that the approval process will be less long. So I think, you know, in summary, we would hope to get approval for both products, all things being equal, because you are dealing with regulatory authorities during next year.
And then on the commercial side here, you're having some early discussions with potential partners.
Yes, up until now, we've been very much focused on obviously delivering the clinical, and very much our strategy moving forward is we want to keep control of this asset, drive it forward, maximize value. And yeah, now we're getting into the really exciting, and for me, the fun bit, really moving ahead with the commercial discussions. You know, we've had a lot of interest in this product. Especially now, because you know the data we've got is really remarkable, and we can make some really strong clinically proven claims. So yes, those discussions will now progress, and we will move forward on that actively, especially once we've got the clinical data report, which is due out by the end of April.
And you say you've seen some strong interest here, have you?
Yeah, we've seen a lot of interest. We've had interest in the past, and that continues. What we haven't done recently is actively go out to promote it. We really wanted to get all the data and the full analysis in. Now that we've got that, we will start really pushing forward on this to look at doing commercial deals. So that really is moving forward. You know, Ken and his team very much driving the regulatory. My team will be looking very much at the commercialization of this product moving forward.
A couple of words, James, you mentioned in the update this morning on the pain relief product. That's still moving forward?
Yes, that's still moving forward. You know, I think unlike Med, we are not completely in control of the process, so we are working with our commercial partners. It is taking longer, and we expect at least another 6 months before we can submit or they can resubmit the MHRA. But the main priority, obviously, is very much Med. We're also progressing with our cannabidiol product, and we hope to update the market more by the end of July. I think it's also worth mentioning, you know, obviously this terrible COVID virus is causing huge disruption around the world, let alone, you know, a lot of deaths. We've always described ourselves as a virtual organization. And I think that is really, you know, coming to the fore now. It is having at the moment very limited impact on us. We've moved to a kind of seamlessly to a home-based operation. And I suppose, thank God for small mercies, we weren't mid-clinical study, because that could have had a really detrimental effect. So, you know, more than by luck and good judgment, the timing of this isn't impacting us at the moment. We're pushing ahead, preparing the dossier submissions, and it's business as usual, to a large extent.
And how's the cash?
The cash is fine. We did a fundraise earlier this year. We're expecting a large tax credit through shortly. We've got enough cash to keep us going, certainly into the mid of next year. So we're in a strong position. And I think it's also important to stress, you know, we burnt a lot of money last year because we were doing a very large extensive clinical study. That is not something we're doing now. We're basically going back to core, unless we have to do further clinical, which we think is unlikely. Our cash burn is a lot less, hence we have a significant cash runway certainly into the middle of next year.
Good to see you, James. Thanks very much.
Thanks, Andrew. Look after yourself.